This is a pasta dish I can almost guarantee you haven't tried before, but I'm pretty sure you're gonna love it. It's creamy, got a tiny bit of a kick to it, some shrimp, and ready in under 10 minutes. This is Bang Bang Shrimp Pasta in the Instant Pot. Keep on watching and we're gonna go through it together. What's up everyone? Welcome to the Four and Fork. My name is Alexandria and this is the Four and Fork where we are cooking one meal from every country in the world. And today's recipe may not be inspired by a country per se, but you all seem to really like my Instant Pot pasta dishes, so I decided to show you another one of our family favorites. Pasta dish that we're making today is called Bang Bang Shrimp Pasta. It is so good. It's creamy, a little spicy, some kick to it, but it's delicious and I know you're really gonna like it. So to get started, we just need to cook the noodles in the pressure cooker. So I have 2.5 cups of chicken broth that I'm gonna add to the pot. And then I also have 8 ounces of dry spaghetti noodles. And if you recall from some of our past recipes, unfortunately a full spaghetti noodle will not fit in the Instant Pot, so I actually have to crack them in half in order to get them to fit. I'm sorry to my Italian grandmother, but it's necessary for us to have some good pasta, so I think she'll forgive. Then I'm gonna put the lid onto the pressure cooker and we're gonna set it to a high pressure for 8 minutes. After the 8 minutes is up, then we will be quick releasing all of the pressure that's left in the pot so that we can open it up and see our beautifully cooked noodles in there. While our pasta is cooking, we're gonna go ahead and cook the shrimp for the dish. So I'm gonna put 1 tablespoon of olive oil in this pan. And then I have 1 pound of raw shrimp. They are uncooked, deveined, no shells, no tails on the shrimp. I bought them frozen and then thawed them, but you can also buy them fresh from your fish counter if yours isn't closed like mine was when I went to the store at 11 p.m. So we're just gonna allow this to heat up and we're gonna cook the shrimp until they turn pink and are cooked all the way through. So you get to choose what you want to prioritize in this recipe. If you absolutely despise doing dishes and you want a one pot meal, then by all means, before you actually cook the pasta in the pressure cooker, you can turn it to the saute function, add the olive oil, and cook the shrimp in the pressure cooker. Remove it, set it aside, and then cook the shrimp in the pressure cooker as well. If you don't mind dishes and you just want dinner on the table as fast as possible, you want an 8 minute cook time and to serve dinner up as soon as you possibly can, then you can do what I'm doing right now, which is cooking the pasta and then preparing the other ingredients while the pasta is cooking in the 8 minute cook time. Now it's time to assemble the Bang Bang sauce. So this sauce is inspired by the Bang Bang sauce at Bonefish Grill with their appetizer. That's the fried shrimp with the Bang Bang sauce. So this is a rendition of that. It's not the exact recipe, but it's my interpretation of how they would make that recipe. I have 2/3 of a cup of mayonnaise, and I'm putting all of this in just like a medium-sized mixing bowl. 1/4 cup of sweet chili sauce, and this you can get in the Asian section of your grocery store. 1 tablespoon of honey for some sweetness. 1.5 teaspoons of lime juice for some tartness. And then if you like sriracha, you can put some sriracha to taste. I am not good with spicy, so I'm just gonna do just a little bit. And then all you have to do is whisk that up. And this is your Bang Bang sauce that you're gonna drizzle over the pasta for the sauce on your pasta dish. So the pressure is released from our pot, so we get to open it up. Lots of steam coming out of there with our freshly cooked pasta. Now, if you're gonna look in your pot, you will notice that there is some liquid left over in there. That is totally okay. You don't have to drain your pasta or anything. The good and sometimes not so good thing about cooking pasta in the Instant Pot is that a lot of the water is left over. The pasta soaks up a lot of the water, but sometimes there's some left. As the pasta gets soaked in the sauce and sits around for a little bit, it soaks up the rest of that liquid. So we're just gonna leave it in there. Don't worry about it. The next step is to spoon our Bang Bang sauce all over the pasta. Drizzle it in there. And I'm gonna kinda use my tongs to just mix the pasta up and make sure that the sauce is all incorporated with the noodles. Again, right now it's gonna look watery, but give it 5 or so minutes and it won't look so watery anymore, it's gonna thicken up. And then lastly to this, we have all of our shrimp that we cooked, our 1 pound of cooked shrimp, so I'm gonna lay those into the pot as well so that they can get incorporated with our pasta and our yummy sauce. If you're really trying to imitate the appetizer recipe from Bonefish Grill that uses Bang Bang sauce, this recipe doesn't call for deep frying the shrimp like that recipe does. So I will leave a link in the description below of some good ways that you can deep fry some shrimp, dip it in some buttermilk, it's really good. And that way if you want to have shrimp cooked that way with your pasta instead, you have that option. I'm just mixing up our pasta here, and as I'm mixing it, you can tell that the sauce is starting to thicken a little bit. It's coating everything a lot nicer. So I'm gonna give it another minute or two and it'll be ready to eat. This recipe for Bang Bang Shrimp Pasta is super quick, ready in an 8-minute cook time, and so delicious, everyone in your family is going to love it. If you need written instructions for the recipe, you can find them in the description of this video. And then don't forget to check out all of the other videos that I have on my YouTube channel. There are Instapot pasta dishes, but then also a myriad of other dishes from all around the world that you can make at home alongside me. Thank you so much for watching this video. Bring some culture to your kitchen this week, and I will see you next week. Bye.